Cubana, how you doing, sir?
I'm good too.
It's good. It's good to have you around.
Thank you so much.
So the last time you came on our IG Live, we really had loads and loads of engagement. Everybody was just, filling the comments up. Hey, Mr. Cubana, how was the experience for you? What would you say people really love about you?
Okay, that's a great interview. It came naturally. I enjoyed the session. I dished out some advice for those who were interested in listening, and I also had a lot of positive feedbacks, showed that that people actually welcomed it, and it's a good
But
experience.
frankly, you seem to be a very, very lovable person. So what would you say that, is responsible for that? Why do people love you so much?
Well, I think maybe because I'm keeping it as simple as possible, as simple and as natural as possible.
True.
I don't need to struggle to form what is not. So this is me, this is who I am, this is who I've always been, and this is who I will always be. So maybe that's it.
So easy does it.
Easy does it, bro.
So, apparently there's a saying, when it comes to the business world that you do not mix business with pleasure, right?
Okay.
But we see Mr. Obi Cubana mixing business with pleasure in such a fantastic way. So what would you say, how are you able to like keep this balance?
My business is pleasure. You understand? So you can't run it without having the pleasure and then additional pleasure too. Our business is like a clinic that takes away stress and gives you back happiness in return, okay? A lot of people who are stressed, they come out here. We give you a wonderful ambience. We give you a good environment, good music, good food, drinks, and everything. And then you live lighter. So my business is run inside pleasure. So I can actually boast that I can mix business
Business with
with
pleasure.
pleasure and get away with
Hey, so
it.
I mean, apparently everybody knows the Cubana brand, right?
Yeah.
But just for the benefit of those people who might be hearing about Cubana for the first time, could you tell us a little bit about what the Cubana Group is?
Okay, the Cubana Group is a hospitality and entertainment
Brand.
brand. We have chains of hotels, restaurants, and nightclubs. The best set of nightclubs you can find anywhere. So it's actually a happiness ground. We breed happiness while making money. Okay? So that's where we measure in. We're going to go into a lot of other things in future, but right now we're just measuring in this entertainment and hospitality, the hotels, the clubs, and the restaurants.
Okay, it's now, I mean, I know it's very challenging in the entertainment space. Business generally in itself is quite challenging. And it's been a long time coming, I would say, right? So at what point did you feel that, like they say, this hustle is not paying? At what point did you reach that,
It's been a very long journey. Social media just made it look as if Kubana came yesterday.
Right.
So prior to that, we've been on the background, toiling, skimming, walking, facing the challenges, up and down. And what will I say? As far back as 10 years ago, we've actually made it big. Because the first Kubana will be 13 years by October this year. 13th October precisely. To be the first one in Wuse 2. The ups and downs of business at the time, Abuja, the Boko Haram era, business became a bit scary, and then we had to move to Port Harcourt. From Port Harcourt, we faced some challenges there, security also. We established the one in Owerri.
All
From
right.
Owerri, we came to Victoria Island, and then this Ikeja 2 years ago. Naturally, nothing is rosy out there. Like this particular place, as beautiful as it looks here right now, we faced the challenges of COVID last year.
Oh,
Being
the
a new
shutdown.
business that was just in the budding stage, we opened here November 22nd, March. There was a lockdown and everything. But I would say that for the past 10 years, it's been going very, very well. No matter the challenges that come across the line, we surmount it. That's life. That's what life is all about. So you can't just be rosy, rosy all the way.
Okay, so with the huge influx of social media now, I mean, everybody has an Instagram account, everybody has a Facebook account. You know, we go on Facebook, we see Obi Cubana, we shout, hey, Baba Koto for us now, you know. It's very easy to sort of, you know, get into this rationale of thinking, you know, you can't just make it overnight, you know. So if you were to go back in time, you know, this is a 20-year-old Obi Cubana now, what advice would you give to this person trying to aspire to become the next Obi Cubana?
I think patience, diligence, hard work. And above all, I think you have to have integrity as a human being. You have to have integrity. You have to, as much as possible, let your word be your word. You see, the problem we have is that, let me give you an example. There was one day, I think that was our 10th year anniversary, and I made a post on my page and said, it's not been easy, 10 years, Cubana, blah, blah, blah. So one guy came to my comment section and wrote, 10 years, no, I know if you wait. So that mentality of we want to make it, but I want to be like you.
Right.
You have to look at the story behind the success. Success doesn't happen overnight. It doesn't happen. It's a 30-year and no rest. You understand?
Right.
So if I were to advise them, you have to work very hard. You have to follow the process. Yes, God's blessings might come differently. Some people might, it might take them very long. Some people might take a short period, but you have to work. You have to be focused. There's no free money out there. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So all this cost soup, nothing like soap anywhere to cut. You have to work for your own soap. You understand?
Right,
so when you're using
right.
the soap, nobody asks you, why is it for me so much?
Right.
Okay? So I believe that also what the world lacks these days is integrity. You have to keep to your word. You have to, if you have business agreement with people, with establishments, with brands, you have to as much as possible respect that. And then you see them coming back. You see things happening. You see it opening doors for you. You see people speaking on your behalf without even you asking for those things. So I think these are the things that people have to learn. People have to imbibe this, and it's a natural key opener to success. Very simple.
True. Just out of curiosity, this guy who you mentioned 10 years to, and he's like, I don't feel it. What was your facial
reaction? I laughed because like this beautiful place right now, there were some messy situations and there were some messy stages. Nobody can see the cement right now. Nobody can see all those. So before you can actually mold it to become something, there will be the struggle behind. You understand? Mm-hmm. So to him, you just came out of an eye because Instagram came and said, Obi Cubana, Obi Cubana. No, it's not been like that. We've been working very hard up till now. People feel I've made it. I have not.
Really?
I have not. Like I said, I've made it. But I'm getting there. I'm focused. I know what I want to be. I know what I want to leave behind. I know the legacies I want to leave behind as a human being. I'm not there yet, but we're on the right path.
Encouraging, quite encouraging, I must say. So there's this, people often say like your network determines your net worth.
Okay.
Now, I mean, seeing that you're quite a very social person, what would you say are the pros of, you know, having this huge network of people to, you can always reach out to, and if there are any downsides, what would you say are the downsides to it as well?
Naturally, everything that has its advantages will always have its disadvantages. My business is built around people.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot do without people. It's about socializing the same people you socialize with. Your network will always bring in back these guys to come and patronize you. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So our business is people-based. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, in dealing with human beings also, you notice that along the line, you must have the disappointments in life. That's natural. That's natural. Because even man disappointed God. So that your ability to turn every situation and then to manage every human being, because every human being is unique. You have to manage everyone, but you cannot do without human being as far as this business is concerned.
But would you say it gets distracting sometimes? Would you say it gets distracting sometimes?
To me, it doesn't. I enjoy every bit of it. I utilize every bit of it. Whatever I see, you turn it to your own advantage. The people who are with you will not distract you, because they are the ones that are making you who you are.
So when you're not working, what will a typical Obi Cubana be doing? How do you cool off? How do you...
Okay, I read a lot.
You read a lot?
I read a lot.
Wow.
I read a lot. So everything I've learned in my life, everything I've applied in my life, I learned in the course of traveling.
Okay.
So I sit down, I lie down, I try to visualize the next step. When people are saying, wow, you've done very well, you're looking at, what's the next step?
Right.
You have to keep wowing them. Because the moment you become irrelevant in the scheme of things, the time is gone. Nobody waits for anybody. You can see all these things, Obi Cubana, because as of today, it's working very well. And Great. You have to keep it that way.
Great. Guys, I mean, feel free, join the conversation. Don't be left out. Just head over to the comment section. We have Mr. Obi Cubana. He's still very much here with us. And, you know, just stay with us till the end. We have a very, very special giveaway for you guys. So, Mr. Obi, back to you. Seeing you build this very successful brand, this very successful Cubana brand from bottom up, were there times when you felt, man, this thing is too hard, I beg, you know, I've had enough, you know? Were there times where you felt, look, let me just give up and I'll move on to the next best thing?
Yeah. Every business, like I said, had its own challenges. Even prior to the Cubana brand, I had other businesses, which at the time, then in FCT, there were demolitions, and it affected me that I said, wow, I picked up my passport, I was going to go to South Africa to go and hustle over there. Luckily for me, I didn't get visa. As simple as South African visa was then, I couldn't get it. So I was like frustrated, I was fed up, and I was like, come on, we got to move. But on the second thought, I was like, what am I looking for out there? Everything I've always wanted in life is here. And I went back to plan B. I started walking, I prayed, somehow I'm a spiritual human being, and I started putting everything I visualized into practice, and it started yielding positive results, and here we are.
Nice. Now, one of the key things people seem to know about Mr. Obi is that you have a very lit Instagram page, right? So, how are you able to manage your business and still manage quite an active fan base on Instagram?
I think Instagram, the more real you keep it, the better. I wake up, I don't even know what to post sometimes. Like if I post half of the things that I encounter every day, I mean, it will be too busy. But then again, I try to put out there what will motivate the next person.
Right.
Yeah. If you see me maybe posting about something materialistic, not just because to show off, but to motivate someone. If you see me lending a helping hand to someone and I post it out there, I will do a write-up just to let you know that these are doable. You can actually do things like this to encourage people. Sometimes I also go to my social part of the posting and everything. I want to show out there that even in the midst of all the challenges, right, you can be happy. You can be happy. So I think my mood for the day determines what I post. And I've been trying as much as possible to keep it as lit as possible.
Yeah. Okay, super. Now, I'll tell you, before scheduling this interview, we were actually debating on what exactly it is you put up, right? Because Mr. Obi seems to be a very stylish man. So
I'll be simple.
simple. You know. So what would you say inspires your fashion sense and, you know, your style, really?
I wouldn't say I'm that. I don't actually go extra my trying to get what I wear. I do a lot of trad. Mm-hmm. You know, I do a lot of prod and a lot of casual. That's me. You hardly ever see me put on tie or put on suit. You know what I'm trying to say?
Yes.
In everything, you have to look good, because first impression is appearance from there.
So, what would you say are the three must-haves for people who are aspiring to venture into business?
In Nigeria?
Yeah, in Nigeria.
Okay. Integrity, I've said it before.
Yeah, you said integrity.
You must have integrity. You must have an open mind. You must have an open mind. And then you must be disciplined. You have to be disciplined. You don't get carried away because of what you see out there. Because I've seen the owner of this other club bought the Lamborghini, let me go and buy. No, you buy it at your own time.
True.
Understand?
True.
Yeah.
True, true. So guys, it's been quite an insightful conversation with Mr. Obi today. We mentioned we have a very special giveaway for you guys. Mr. Obi has been keeping us woke for the past, how many minutes now? I can't keep track. So head over to your Instagram page and let us know 3 takeouts you have based off the conversation with Mr. Obi today. Do well to follow us at Fidelity Bank PLC on Instagram and tag 3 of your friends on this post. And who knows, we're giving out 200,000 naira for you to come have a good time here at Cubana. So guys, I mean, it's up to you. We'll be hoping to hear from you. So Mr. Obi, what will be your parting advice to our audience today?
Well, from everything we've said, you have to keep it real. Keep working very hard. Be focused on whatever you do. There's nothing like soup out there to be cooked for anyone. You understand? So you work. You have integrity as a human being. And then be as nice as possible. Work very hard. There's a lot of opportunities had in Nigeria. You know, a lot.
But people keep complaining, though.
Right from day one, people keep complaining. That's much for you. But there are, I'm telling you that, there are a lot of things. There are a lot of opportunities here in Nigeria. A lot, a whole lot.
Okay, guys, that's the most we can take for today's episode. Thank you so very much, Mr. Obi, for making up time. And guys, we will catch you same time next week with yet another special guest. So hey, just head over to our Instagram page and do well to smash that follow button so you get to know once we go live. All right. So right here at Cubana, it is peace out. Bye for now. Okay. Cheers.
Cheers, bro.